Hello friends and welcome to Microsoft Advanced Excel Training. This is Ramzan Rajani and in this video you will be learning how to separate first name and last name with the help of text to column option of Microsoft Excel. After I complete the explanation, we will also do the practical together. So make sure you have text-to-column.xls file ready on your shared drive or on the desktop. So let's get started. I'm opening a file with the name text-to-column. So I will go to desktop, that is Excel training folder. In that I have a file with the name text-to-column. I have opened the file. In this file, friends, I have four sheets. First is employee names, another is the product, third is the department code, and fourth is the city name. On the first two sheets, that is employee name and product one sheet, I will be giving you explanation. And the practicals we will be doing on department code sheets and the city name sheets. So let's get started. Now, over here, if you will see the A column, which is having full name, Jeff Lenning, John Smith. Now over here, first name and last name is together. Now I have a requirement to separate first name and last name. So over here, I have a delimiter as a comma. So on the basis of comma, I can divide first name and last name. So how do I divide that? If you have a very big list, 500, 1000 records are there, and if you want to do it manually, it will take lots of time. Instead of this, you can use a beautiful function, beautiful option of Excel, that is the text to column. Let's see how you can separate it quickly. The first step in doing that is you will select the data. After selecting the data, you will go to data ribbon, which is over here, and in data ribbon you will get an option text to column. If you will read what it says separate the contents of one Excel cell into separate columns. So after selecting the data, I am clicking on text to column. When you click on text to column, you will get this option over here. If you will see, step 1 of 3 means in doing text to column you have only 3 steps, and now you are on the first step, that is step 1st of 3. Here you get two options, one is delimited, another is fixed width. So first we will see what is delimited. So after selecting on delimited, I will click on next. If you will see, you will get the preview also over here. So whatever data you have selected, it has shown you the preview. And now after selecting delimited, I will say next. So now you can see this is the second step. And now he is asking you what is your delimiters, means which is your divider, means on what basis you want to separate first name and last name. There should be one separator. So in this data, I have comma as a separator. So I want wherever there is a comma, from that position it should take the other data to the next cell. So here I will remove the delimiters as tab and I will say comma is my separator. You can see in the data preview, the data is looking something like this. As soon as I click on the comma, the preview should change. So I will click on separator is comma. Can you see over here? It has changed. See, again I am removing the comma. Again it has become original. Again I am clicking on comma. So again he has separated. So now my text is separated. Now I will say next. So now it is a third step. In third step, you can skip some columns also. Let's say while pulling the data, you don't want this column to be inserted. So over here you will come and you can say do not import the column. As of now, I want to import both, so I will keep the option as it is and just I will say finish. As soon as you say finish, this will be divided. Do you want to replace the content of a destination cell? Just say OK and your cell is divided. So this way you can separate the first name and last name. Afterward you can select this and directly you can move it over here, and if you want you can delete this column, and your work is done. This was the first example in which the separator was comma. Now I am going to second sheet. So while moving to the second sheet, you can click on product one sheet. This is one option to select the another sheet. I am using a shortcut. So the shortcut to move to the next sheet is control page down. Again, I want to come to the employee name sheet, again I can press control page up. Again I am pressing control page down to move to next sheet. So control page up, control page down is a shortcut for moving between sheets. If you want, you can write down this shortcut in your book. Now let me give you another example. Now pay attention friends, here you have different scenario. Over here you have two columns, one is product and second is the amount. Over here in product, XY is the name of the product and 101 is the code of the product. AB is the name of the product and 556 is the code of the product. I want to separate product name and product code, means I want to separate XY and 101 in two different columns. Now here the problem will be when you will separate it, this 101 will overwrite on the column B. So what we will do is, before doing text to column, you will create one blank column so that in that column your product name should come, product ID should come. So I will click on this column and I will right click on it and I will say insert column, means I have selected the entire column, right click and say insert. One column will be inserted before amount. So I have got a blank column over here. Now when I will divide product column, it will come in two different columns. So I have a blank column in which 101 should come. So let's see how to do that. The first step is always selection. So I will come on A2 and I will press control shift down. So I have selected the entire data. Again I am scrolling up with the help of scroll bar, which is on the extreme right side. You can see over here going up. So after selecting the data friends, I will go to data and over here I will say option text to column. Click on text to column and over here again three steps. You will select delimited. This is the preview of the data. I will say next. And now over here, on what basis you want to divide? In the previous example, John Smith, there was a comma as a separator. Here I don't have comma, but yes, I have a space. So I will say space is my delimiter. So over here, I will come and I will say space. So my space is the separator and now he has separated your data. Just say next. Again, you say finish, the third step. And your work is done. So you have product code. So I can write over here code and you say product number. Your work is done. This way you can do text to column and can separate on the basis of some separator. Now let's do practice together for the two different sheets, that is the department code and the city name. So I will request you to open a file text to column which is there on your desktop, or if you have shared on the shared drive, just open the file. So we'll wait for a few seconds so that you all can open the file. Great. Now let's go to the next sheet, that is department code sheet. Separation of department code, we will do it together. So let's get started. So everybody come on department code sheet, and after coming over here, let's select the data. So I will come on A2 cell, and after coming on A2 cell, if you want, you can directly select it like this with the help of mouse. But if you have more data, then again you have to drag it so much. Instead of that, a quick method of this is what? Come on A2 cell. After coming on A2 cell, just press control shift and down arrow key. Control shift down arrow key, and then with the help of scroll bar, which you can see on the extreme right, drag it upwards, drag it up, so you will get the above data. After selecting this, friends, you all go to data ribbon, and in data click on text to column. So you will click on text to column. After this is the first step. Click on delimited. Default it will be delimited, but still click it so that you get practice. And this is the preview of your data. Your screen should look exactly my screen is looking. So over here I will say next. Now you tell me, what is the divider over here? What is the separator over here? Correct, the separator over here is the hyphen. So I want to divide on the basis of hyphen. So wherever there is a hyphen, the text should come in the next column. So over here I have tab, I have semicolon, I have comma, I have space. I don't have the hyphen over here. So what I will do, this is the extra character. So I will go to others. So everybody click on others, and over here in this box type hyphen, which is next to zero key and which is before to the plus key. So I will type hyphen. You can see the text has been divided. You will say next, and then you will say finish. Your work is done. So this way you can divide the department code on the basis of hyphen. Let's take another example so that we get hands on. So again I will go to the next sheet, that is city name. So everybody press control page down. So it will take you to the last sheet. Again over here I have location, and here I want to divide again the name of the cities. So I will come here and I will select the data. So how you will select? After coming on A2, you will press control shift down. So you have selected all the 28-29 records. With scroll bar, come up. Now you should be little bit fast because you have already done the practice in the first step, that is for the department codes. After selecting the data, you will go to data ribbon. In data ribbon you will get an option text to column. Click on delimited, say next, and over here now I want to divide on the basis of comma. So I will remove others from here and I will say comma, and then you will say next, and then you will say finish. Your work is done. If you don't want this data, you can just select and say control minus, or from delete key you can press the delete. Control minus is nothing but to delete a column, which we will see after some time. So this way, friends, you can separate the first name and last name. This way you can separate the product codes. Like you separate first name and last name over here, which we have done in the employee name sheet, in the same way you can merge also. So you have first name in one column, you have last name in one column, you can merge that. How to merge that? For merging you don't have direct option, but you have to use some small formula. You might have heard about the concatenate formula, so which we will see after some time. Thanks friends for watching the video. Hope you have understood now how to work with text to column. Thank you so much and happy learning.